Hello, and welcome to episode 9 of Let's Play Civilization 6. One feature I'm kind of missing with this is I wish there was a last trade route sent when a trade route is up, because sometimes I don't know if I'm sending to the same trade route. I already have one to Buffalo, you can see here, and the option is still here. And I have one to New York. Do I have one to New York yet? No. Let's send this one to New York for now. And what I should be doing is buying a worker here to speed up the production, because it's taking forever. Can I buy units? Yes, I can, but can't really buy a battleship right now. So I'll stop that for now, and I also want another worker here. Oh, the other thing, I was looking at this yesterday after I recorded episode 8, is I was thinking to myself, what happened to the Rough Riders? And it turned out that because I was hitting up all the Eureka techs, that I had skipped the bottom half of the tech tree. So starting from Siege Tactics, I would get the Rough Riders at the end with the rifling. These are both boosted, but this one isn't, because I never built own two bombards. I don't know what that is. I assume that's a type of fort. So how far am I away from replaceable parts? I'm gonna finish that. I'm gonna come back and work on this. Oh, I need coal to get battleships. That's probably why I couldn't build it. And I don't have steam power either. I need to have two shipyards. That's a very high price. Anyways, yeah, let's do that. And I'm one turn away from nationalism. What does this do? Open civics tree. Oh, I can create Army Corps, so that's like combining two units to make one stronger unit. And that's kind of like what you get in the Civilization Revolutions games. Although, in that game, if you don't combine your units, you're pretty much asking to lose, because there's no way you're going to win without combining your units. Here, it's more strategic, I think. Okay, let me... rest these up. Let's rest this guy. Okay.
We have furthered our agricultural technology yet again. Each farm that we build next to another will increase the output of both. I suggest we do this as often as possible. Our military has learned a way of combining two units into larger scale core. These core units are much more powerful than their singular counterparts.
Okay, so I'm getting these tooltips come up because I have the settings set as new to Civ 6, so eventually I'll turn this off. It's just nice to have the reminders.
For a machine to run smoothly and predictably, its parts must be standard and hence replaceable. Human nature, as manifested in tribalism and nationalism, provides the momentum of the machinery of human evolution.
Okay, I do want to check out what the core system do in terms of maintenance costs. No? It's not in the Civilopedia. Weird. Let me see here. Okay, can upgrade these guys to form core. Oh no, okay. Let me kill this first. Or not. That didn't work. But I can form core with this guy, right? Yeah. Okay, let's see what's being worked. That's being worked. That's being worked. Let's do siege tactics. Is that the name of their battleship? Minas Gerais? Let's form a core here. Meanwhile, I'm going to upgrade my units to infantry. Let's build a monument. Actually, no. Get the water mill out first. Oh, I have an artillery here. I'm gonna move this one up. I'm gonna send this guy to New York. Yeah, let's see what I have at New York. That's being worked. Let's move him here. Wait, that's a mistake. Click that guy. There we go. So I can move my builder one turn and improve that right away. The Ruhr Valley, let's dump some more shields into that one. Okay. Yeah, they really don't like us anymore. Actually, I want to see how much warmonger penalty I have. Oh, they've sailed away. Okay, I'm going to upgrade. Can I upgrade that? No. Let's see here. Rio de Janeiro. Purchase sewer. Let me purchase another builder up here to improve some of these stuff. Because the production here is really bad. Twenty-three turns to repair granary? That's not right. What's going on here? Oh, I have really low amenities for some reason. Let me dig into this some more. There should be a trade route through here, they should be connected. What district is this that I pillaged? The commercial hub is pillaged, okay. Okay. I have to watch my money now. I'm actually losing money since I'm upgrading so much. Build a mine. Did that go through? Jump too quickly. Okay, I did build a mine there. Okay. I'm gonna take this city next. Just some nice resources, and I'll have touching borders with New York eventually. I wonder what they're doing with this battleship. I think they're going to move it here to attack it.
Lupenzi volulenda kutudatiki sana yaki yaki.
Uh-oh, I think they're claiming more to us. Luveko. Yeah, they just declared war on us. Okay, that should be interesting. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. Send that to India. Ah. I'm gonna start moving some of my units back here because I don't know where the Congolese are gonna attack. Oh, I guess I can't repair this. I have to do this through the city, but I can send this guy over here. Or here, I think, to build a sawmill. Okay. Oh, there is another city here. Salvador de Bahia. One, two. Okay, I can park him here, I think. Yeah, I need to be improving. Washington hasn't done much improvements. I'm gonna send this guy over here to improve a few things. Incredible. Here. Oh shoot, there's a battleship. Let's rest it for now. Send these to the Chinese cities. Which ones do I have? Move that settler back here. Oh, I don't want to have peace with you yet. Let's keep that in Washington. Man, artillery with the in corps system is just insanely powerful. They did reduce your range to 2, which is good, I guess. It's not as overpowered as in Civ 5. Start building some units here. Rest him for a bit. What? Lost 1,000 gold?
Hello.
That sucks. I guess I should get into the spying game myself. Keep this to Buffalo for now.
Your Excellency, I feel it is time to build some neighborhoods to house our growing populace. We should build these on our most beautiful lands, near natural wonders, or perhaps by the coast.
Huh.
Neighborhoods with higher appeal will house more citizens, whereas neighborhoods built by marsh, airports, or rainforests are not going to be very populated at all.
It's the Industrial Revolution and the growth of urban concentrations that led to a sense of anonymity.
Okay, I'm not sure why this unit isn't healing up. Is there a problem? It's been like this forever. Let me move him into the city. Heal, fine, heal, healed. Okay, we can build national parks if we research this. What does this give us? Okay, let's do Scorched Earth.
The industrial heart of Germany practically stopped beating. Hardly anyone worked, hardly anything ran. The population of the Ruhr area had to be supported by the rest of the country.
Let's build our harbor. This is one of the improvements in Civ 6, is you don't have to have your cities by the coast to be able to build a harbor. As long as they have tile access to water, they can build one eventually. Here. Okay, it tells me how many I can house. Tundra actually has pretty good appeal. I might as well put it here. It's not a good tile to use. Finally, your army showed up. Okay, I think this is a good place to end this episode. The next episode, we'll try to take the city, which is not your capital city, and see how badly this war with the Congolese are going. So far, I've only seen two units coming this way. And I'm trying to get to the Rough Riders so I can upgrade some of my horse units to be able to defend my eastern side of my empire. Okay, thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time.